Hunting and rituals are an integral part of their lives even to this day. They are the Konda Reddys of Andhra Pradesh. The Konda Reddys are one of the primitive tribes of India. They live in the jungles of Khammam, East Godavari and West Godavari districts of Andhra Pradesh. But the majority lives in the East Godavari district. There is no evidence about the origin of this tribe. The Reddys believe that Bhimanna, the Pandava deity of Poppy Hills, first created the earth, the hills and then the Reddys. One man and one woman. He then put them inside a gourd and let them down on the earth. But anthropologists say that this tribe is more ancient than the Austroasiatic and Dravidian populations of this area. The Konda Reddys belong to the same group of shifting cultivators like the Didais, Kolams, Konda Doras and Konda Bhagatas. The Reddys seem to have lost their original language. Today they speak Telugu with a slant accent and clipped words. The Reddys first appear in recorded history in 1571 during the rule of Golconda. History reveals that Reddys revolted against the East India Company in 1802 and 1879. Opposing the irregular revenue settlements and heavy taxation. In 1922, during the freedom movement, they waged a guerrilla war for 2 years under the leadership of Alluri Sri Ramaraju. This nearly unsettled the British. The name Konda Reddy means hill headman. The Poppy Hills was their unique domain for a long time. But migrations from surrounding areas brought other tribal groups like the Koya Doras, Konda Kambaras and Valmikis. The Reddys consider the other tribal groups inferior to them. Thus they either live in exclusive single community villages or generally build their huts away from the other tribes in multi-ethnic villages. They do not eat food cooked by other tribes. Nor do they allow them into their homes. However, all the communities live in perfect harmony. Traditionally, the Konda Reddy men dress in a loincloth and sometimes a turban. They comb their long hair into a bun. Earlier, they wore ear studs and bead necklaces. The women dressed in short narrow saris. Originally, they wore plated cane and shell jewelry, which was replaced by beads, metal bracelets and anklets. They wore many earrings. Besides a nose stud on each nostril, there is a glass studded pendant called Addabasa on the septum. But the interaction with the outside world has brought about many changes in the attire of the men and women. The traditional house is usually square. The walls are built with wattle mats and plastered with mud. The floor is raised from the ground and the roof is low-lying to protect from the heavy monsoons and hot summers. The house normally consists of a closed inner room and a veranda. The room is used for keeping household goods, while the veranda is used as a living space. The Reddy's life is one of intense labor. It centers on procuring food for their needs through a slash and burn shifting cultivation called podu. Though plow cultivation is on the increase, a majority of the Reddys still depend on podu. On an average, each family cultivates about 1 to 3 acres. They normally grow drought-resistant and rain-fed millets like ragi, jowar, bajra, maize, and pulses like red gram and green gram, besides various vegetables. They also grow paddy in some areas. The cropping is always mixed so that different crops would come to harvest at different times, ensuring food security. Before they reap any crop, they perform the first eating ceremony called Kotta. They believe that the hill deities will become angry if they eat the crop before the ceremony. The Reddy's most usual food is a gruel called java, which is their staple meal. For many weeks in a year, they survive on food from the forest. However, after the harvests, they eat millets and rice with a stew called kura. In this stew, they add meat, fish, various vegetables, roots, fruits and pulses. But eating beef is a grave breach of tribal law, which can be punished with excommunication. Food is normally roasted, stewed, or made into a gruel, but it is not fried. Toddy is their favorite drink. During the toddy season, it is common to find toddy clubs in every village. There are no social restrictions. Usually the men tap toddy from the palm or the kariota tree. Though every village has enough supply, they even purchase in times of shortage. The Reddys generally do not use milk, although they keep cattle for agricultural purposes. They rear pigs, goats and fowls, which are an important source of income. They also earn some money from forest labor, minor forest produce and basket weaving. Nearly every activity of their life starts with ceremonial worship. They worship deities considered superior to nature for a comfortable and peaceful life. The main deities are the earth mother called Bhumi Devata and the hill deities called Konda Devatas. The Reddys also accepted the concept of village deities from the neighboring Telugus and Koyas. These days, they even pray to Hindu gods, and in some places, they have converted to Christianity. Pujari and Veju are the most important personalities of the Konda Reddy religion. Pujari, the priest, functions when the gods are benevolent. He makes offerings and prayers for the welfare of the community and conducts all traditional rites and ceremonies. He doesn't require any special skill or training. Thank you. Mystic Man is the messenger between the community and the supernatural. He also identifies and cures diseases, besides treating cases of black magic and evil spirits. An important aspect is the presence of female virtues, who enjoy the same respect as the male ones in their society. Konda Reddy women do not enjoy any property rights. However, the husband and wife jointly make all decisions concerning the house and cultivation. And if a woman is unhappy in her marriage, she can just elope with another man. Normally, it is the woman who initiates the divorce. Although the women conduct all social functions like weddings, they do not have a say in the village council. The village council called Gotti resolves all decisions and disputes, which is normally presided by the village headman. All families of the village are represented in this council. Every decision has to be approved by the council members. The council works in a very democratic way. If any dispute is not resolved, the parties appeal to the tribal headman, who has authority over many villages. Adultery, marital dues, breach of exogamy laws, like dining with prohibited castes, are the main cases dealt by the council. Nowadays, the village administration is handled by the panchayat system. The Reddy society is governed by exogamous clans. Clan members are considered descendants of common ancestors and are known by a common name or family name. Descent is strictly patrilineal, and the marriage includes a ceremony where the bride is transferred to her husband's clan. According to the laws of exogamy, members of the same clan are not allowed to marry. This can result in excommunication. The bridegroom bears all the wedding expenses, and the wedding takes place in his village. He has to pay the bride price, called Oli. Cross-cousin marriages, called Menari Kam, are very common in the Konda Reddys. Normally, the maternal uncle has the first right on the girl. However, there are various methods of finding a maid. Usually, the parents arrange the marriage, but only with the consent of the boy and the girl. This system gained importance as the proper method due to the influence of immigrant Hindus. Marriage of a girl before puberty is also a custom adopted from the Hindus. A method very popular with young men and women is marriage by elopement, called Moganalu. Generally, it happens during the festival times. The couple may or may not have a formal wedding. However, premarital sex and even prolonged love affairs are not a problem in the Konda Reddy society. In marriage by servitude, the groom lives in the father-in-law's house. In such cases, he need not pay the bride price. In marriage by capture, the groom simply takes away the girl of his choice, either announced or unannounced to the future in-laws. This method is not very common. Widow remarriages and divorce are customarily approved practices in the Konda Reddy society. Polygamy is allowed, but it is not very frequent. When a married woman elopes with another man, then he may have to pay her first husband, the bride's money, and all the marriage expenses. Earlier, weddings were simpler. The wedding was performed without the help of any outsiders. But today it has become more expensive and elaborate. Now it is compulsory to use the services of other caste groups like barbers and drummers. Nowadays, the Jangam or Brahmin priest conducts the marriage rites. With increased education, inter-tribe marriages have also become common in multi-ethnic villages. The direct result of integrating with the mainstream is that the men are now demanding dowry. The Konda Reddys believe that the planetary ill effects cause diseases and death. They have a strong faith in black magic. When they are ill, they consult the Vedjus. The Vedju uses his mystic ways and gets into a trance. They believe that the hill deity speaks to him about what medicines to apply and what animals to sacrifice. They sacrifice animals to the village deities to protect them from diseases. Not all ailments are caused by the supernatural. Even natural causes of disease are recognized. Natural disease is treated with herbal medicine. The Vedju collects various medicinal plants from the surrounding forest and makes medicines, which are used for common diseases like wounds, bump pox and sterilization. But the use of tribal medicine sustains only in remote villages. In villages exposed to the outside world, people prefer modern medicine. If a woman dies in childbirth, she is buried or burnt with normal rites. An aborted fetus or a stillborn child is buried in the jungle. If a Reddy dies in any other village, his funeral rites are generally conducted there itself. They do not have a concept of soul, but a man who dies due to black magic and a pregnant woman who dies before childbirth is believed to become an evil spirit. At such times, the Vedju is called to banish the spirits into the forest. There is no meal at the funeral, but 3 weeks after the funeral, a funeral feast is held. At all ceremonial feasts, a little food is kept aside for the dead relatives. Festivals and the Konda Reddy religion are usually ceremonial rituals. The ceremonies vary from place to place and there is no fixed date on which a festival is held. Each village decides its own date for the festival. Nearly all the festivals are interwoven with agriculture, starting from the sowing of seeds to harvesting the crop. Every activity begins only after conducting a festival for the concerned deity. Most festivals are actually first eating ceremonies for various crops. The new crop is cooked in the jungle after offering it along with sacrificed animals for the Konda Devatas. The sacrificed animal is cooked and eaten along with the new crop. Only men attend this ceremony. The women cook and eat in their homes. All first eating ceremonies are a low-key affair, but the ceremonies for mango and beans are very elaborate. Food, according to the Reddys, is the main medium whereby impurity is transmitted. Thus, women are not allowed to cook on ceremonial occasions, during menstruation and after childbirth. In addition to these festivals are the Bhudevi Pandaga, Gangalamma Pandaga and Vanadevudu Pandaga, which are done to ensure good rains and good harvests. The Bhumi Devata festival is done to encourage the Earth Mother to give an abundant harvest. The blood from the sacrificed animals is mixed with the seed grain to increase their fertility. The seeds are later added to the rest of the grain before sowing. Earlier days, in certain villages, even human sacrifices were offered to bring good rain and a bumper harvest. This practice is said to have stopped. The Reddys never interacted with the outside world, except to buy clothes and salt at the weekly shanty. Earlier, they did not have a concept of property or money. However, private ownership came about with plough cultivation and with the issue of pattas by the government. Barter was replaced by money with the introduction of forest labor in the early 20th century, where they were paid in cash. The sons always inherit the property and daughters have no share.
Kunkunna sale, na ja jambare, kunkunna sale, na ja jambare.
For a long time, the Konda Reddys remained the most backward tribe in this area. But in the last 10 years, various infrastructure facilities like roads, irrigation and borewells have been constructed, even in the remotest areas. In the last census, literacy was less than 5% in most areas, and many villages had zero literacy. Due to the concentrated efforts of the local ITDA, today the literacy level is around 22%, even in the most remote villages. As a result of the improved communications with the outside world and education, the previously detached Reddys are now joining the mainstream. The Konda Reddy is still looking back into his past, but now there is a new determination to make up for all the lost time.
Amudivankara,